بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam and upon his family, his companions, and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, ikhwan, fa nawasilu ma'akum fi hadhi al-yawm al-mubarak awnan min ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So we continue, inshallah ta'ala, in this blessed and noble day of ours, seeking the aid and the assistance of our Lord, the most merciful and the most compassionate. Dhakira nafsi wa yakum, reminding ourselves firstly, and our brothers and our sisters secondly. Mustafidina wa muta'allimina min sharhi al-imam al-allama al-sheikh Abdulaziz ibn Abdullah bin Ibaz rahimahullah ta'ala على كتاب أصول الثلاثة للإمام المجدد شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب التميمي رحمه الله تعالى رحمه الله تعالى. So we continue learning from, benefiting from the explanation of the noble Imam, الشيخ عبد العزيز بن عبد الله بن باز. May Allah have mercy upon him as he comments and explains the book of Shaykh al-Islam, the reviver of the Sunnah, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Tamimi, one of his tremendous books, Usul al-Thalatha. فَوَصَلْنَا إِلَىٰ قَوْلِهِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ. So we have arrived at his words, where he says, الرَّابِعَ, and the fourth principle, and the fourth principle. قال الرابعة الصبر على الأذى فيه. الصبر على الأذى فيه. So he says point number four, or principle number four, that the person has patience upon the harm that he encounters. طيب يا إخوان أظن أخذنا هذا. I think that we have taken that. والله تعالى أعلم. طيب قال الإمام والرابعة الصبر على الأذى فيه. على الأذى فيه. So he says point number four, that the person is patient and endures patience upon the harm that he encounters. قال الإمام ابن عبد العزيز ابن باز رحمه الله تعالى. He says, أي يصبر على الأذى فيه وفي هذه الأشياء. وقد يحصل للإنسان أذى قد يتعب من المدعو أو غيره. So he says here that the person is patient regarding the harm that he may encounter. He says meaning that the individual, he is patient upon the harm that he may encounter regarding these particular affairs. فقد يحصل للإنسان أذى قَدْ يَتَعَبُ مِنَ الْمَدْعُ أَوْ غَيْرِهِ. He says, for indeed the individual, it may befall him some harm. Some harm may befall him. So he says, and this harm could come from the one that is calling or the one that is being called, and it can come from other than him. مِنْ أَهْلِهِ أَوْ غَيْرِهِمْ. And this harm can come from his family, his close relatives, or other than them. فالواجب الصبر واحتساب الأجر عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. سبحانه وتعالى. So he says, what's incumbent, what's a must, what's obligatory upon the individual is that he is patient and he seeks the reward with his Lord سبحانه وتعالى. فبين الإمام ابن باز ها هنا يا إخوان أن العبد ربما ماذا ربما يحصل من أهله أو من غير أهله الأذى. والواجب على من يدعو لله سبحانه وتعالى ولي دين الله سبحانه وتعالى ولسنة نبي الله سبحانه وتعالى يجب عليه الصبر. يجب عليه أمام هذا الأذى الصبر. So here, Al-Imam Ibn Abbas is clarifying for us, Ikhwan, that perhaps from time to time, the individual who's calling to Allah, calling to the religion of Allah, calling to the sunnah of the Prophet of Allah, that perhaps from his family or other than his family, he may face some harm. He may face some difficulty from them. And what's incumbent upon him, what's a must upon him, what's obligatory upon him, this individual, is that he is patient. وَاحْتِسَابُ الْأَجْرِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And that he's seeking with his patience the reward of his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا يَكُونُ صَابِرًا وَاحْتِسَابًا لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لِأَجْرِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَهُوَ مَعْجُورٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ مَعْجُورٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. For indeed this individual, if he is patient and he's seeking the reward with his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَنِيَتُهُ تَكُونُ خَالِصًا, and his intention is correct, is sincere, فهو معجور عند الله, then this individual, he is rewarded in the sight of Allah. فقال الإمام ابن باز رحمه الله. So the Shaykh Abdulaziz ibn Baz continues. قال فالمؤمن يصبر على إيمانه بالله. He says, so the individual, the believer, the true believer of Allah, he is patient when it comes to the belief of Allah. وَيَسْبُرْ عَلَى الْعَمْرِ بِمَا أَوْجَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. And he is patient when it comes to carrying out those actions from the affairs that Allah has made obligatory upon him. وَتَرَكَ مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. And he leaves off those things that Allah has made haram upon him. وَيَسْبِرُ فِي الدَّعْوَةِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And he is patient when it comes to calling the people to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْتَعْلِيمِ وَالْأَمْرِ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهِ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And he is patient when it comes to teaching the people the religion. And he is patient when it comes to enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. فَلَا بُدَّ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ فِي هَذِهِ الْأُمُورِ كُلِّهَا. So it's a must for the individual that he is patient with regards to these affairs. All of it, with regards to these affairs, all of them. فَالدِّينُ كُلُّهُ يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى صَابِرٍ. So the religion of Allah, all of it, the individual is in need of patience. فَبَيَّنَ الْإِمَامُ بِنُ بَعْسُونَ يَخْوَانَ فَضَّلَ وَمَنْزِلَ وَرِفَعَ هَذَا الْأَمْرِ الْعَظِيمِ عَلَى وَهُوَ الصَّبْرِ عَلَى وَهُوَ الصَّبْرِ. So Imam Abdulaziz ibn Abbas is clarifying for us the station and the prestige and the status ماذا of this tremendous affair, and it is patience. أَيْنَ نَحْنُ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. Where are we from having patience, يَا إِخْوَانَ. فَالْإِمَامُ يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. So the Imam is in need of patience. وَالشَّيْخُ يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. And the Shaykh is in need of patience. وَالْأَبْ يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. And the father is in need of patience. وَالْأُمُّ تَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. And the mother is also in need of patience. وَطَالِبُ الْعِلْمِ يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. And the students of knowledge is also in need of patience. وَالدَّاعِي إِلَى اللَّهِ يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى صَبْرِ. And the one who's calling to the religion of Allah, he's in need of patience. قَالَ يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى صَبْرِ صَبْرٍ عَلَى دَعْوَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ. So he said the religion of Al-Islam is in need of patience. The person is in need of patience when it comes to fulfilling the religion of Al-Islam. He says when it comes to calling to Allah alone. وَصَبْرٍ عَلَىٰ أَن تُصَلِّ. And the person has to be patient when it comes to prayer. وَتُزَكِّ. And when it comes to you giving your zakah, it's upon you to be patient. قال وتصوم وتحج وتأمر بالمعروف وتنهى عن المنكر. And when you perform the fast and when you enjoin the good and forbid the evil, it's upon you to be patient. قال وصبر على المهارم والسيئات. And it's upon you to be patient when it comes to staying away from the prohibitions and staying away from those sins. فَتَحْذَرُوا مِنْ قُرْبِهَا. And when it comes to being on guard and staying away from coming close to those sins and prohibition, it's upon you to be patient. فَالْإِنسَانُ إِذَا لَمْ يَصْبِرْ وَقَعَ فِي مَا حَرَّمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. So the individual, what happens when he's not patient? He falls into those things that Allah has made prohibited upon him. أَوْ تَرَكَ مَا أَوْجَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Or he may not fall into what's haram, but he may leave off those things that Allah Ta'ala has made obligatory upon him. فَعِنْدَ عَدِمِ الصَّبْرِ الْعَبْدُ إِمَّا يَقَعْ فِي الْمُهَرَّمَاتِ أَوْ إِمَّا يَقَعْ فِي تَرُكِ مَا أَوْجَبَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ. So the person, when he does not have patience, he is not patient, then one of two things happens. Either he falls into those things that Allah has made haram, or he leaves off fulfilling, carrying out those things that Allah Ta'ala has made obligatory upon him. قال ولهذا قال الله تعالى لرسوله في سورة الأحقاف. He says, so for this reason, Allah Ta'ala says in سورة الأحقاف, قال فاصبر كما صبر أولو العزم من الرسل. So he says that Allah Ta'ala says, so therefore be patient just as those أولو العزم من الرسل, those head messengers, be patient like they were patient. Surah Al-Ahqaf. وَقَالَ سُبْحَانَ وَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. Surah Tur. And Allah Ta'ala also mentions, and be patient, O Muhammad, لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ, due to the ruling, the judgment of your Lord. For indeed you are underneath our sight. For indeed we see you. Surah Tur. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَاسْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Surah Nahl. And Allah Ta'ala, he says, and be patient, for indeed your patience is only for Allah, for the sake of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Nahl. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى إِنَّمَا يُوَفَى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Surah Zumar. And Allah Ta'ala mentions, verily those who are patient, they are going to be rewarded in full without being mada, without hisab, without receiving a reckoning. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَاسْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Surah Al-Anfal. And Allah Ta'ala, he says, and be patient, for indeed Allah is with those who are patient. For indeed Allah is with those who are patient. فَمِنْ هَذِي الْآيَاتِ نستفيد يا إخوان عدة أمور. So from these ayat, we benefit many benefits. الأولى من فوائد سورة الأحقاف, أو هذه الآية التي تقع في سورة الأحقاف, from the verse that comes in سورة الأحقاف, نستفيد بأن صبر سنة من سنن أولي الأزم من الرسل. From the ayat that comes in سورة الأحقاف, we benefit that patience is a sunnah from the sunan of those chief messengers, the head messengers, Muhammad, Ibrahim, Nuh, Isa, wa Musa. Anna sabra min sunanihim. That patience is from their sunnah. That patience is from their sunnah. فَإِذَا مَنَّ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَى الْعَبْدِ بِالصَّبَرِ فهي أمر قدمنا الله تعالى على أولي العزم من الرسل. So when the person, the servant of Allah, is blessed with this tremendous bounty, this affair of being patient, then this is an affair that Allah similarly bestowed upon those tremendous messengers. على محمد وعلى إبراهيم وعلى نوح وعلى عيسى وعلى موسى عليهم الصلاة والسلام. عليهم الصلاة والسلام. ومن الآية التي تقع في سورة التور, and from the verse that comes in سورة التور, نستفيد بأن الصبر ماذا أمر من أوامر الله. And from the verse that comes in سورة التور, إخوان, we benefit that patience is a commandment from the commandments of Allah. أمر الله تعالى على عبد أن يصبروا. That Allah commanded the servant to be patient. وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ. Be patient due to the reward and the judgment, the judgment and the ruling of your Lord. فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. For indeed you are under our vision. You are under our sight. Suratu Tur. Suratu Tur. وَمِنْ الْآيَةِ الَّتِي تَقَعْ فِي سُورَةِ الزُّمَرِ. And from the verse that comes in Suratu Zumar. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. That verily those who are patient, they will receive their reward in full. بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Without any reckoning. نَسْتَفِيدُ مِنْ هَذَا مَذَا مِنْ فَضْلِ الصَّبَرِ. We benefit firstly from the virtues of patience. From the virtues of patience. فَإِذَا لَا عَبْدُ يَكُونُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ مَذَا يتوفى أو يتوفون أجرهم يوم القيامة بغير حساب. فهذه الفائدة الأولى. So the first benefit here in this ayah, that the one who was among those who are patient, he's going to receive his reward in full يوم القيامة بغير حساب, without having any reckoning. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. والفائدة الثانية فضل صبر. And the second benefit is the virtues of patience. The virtues of patience. وفي الآية التي تقع في سورة الأنفال. And from the verse in سورة الأنفال. واصبروا إن الله مع الصابرين. Be patient. For indeed Allah is with those who are patient. نستفيد من هنا ثلاثة فوائد. Three benefits we benefit here. الأولى فضل الصبر. Benefit number one, the virtues of patience. والثانية أن الصبر أمر من أوامر الله. Benefit number two, that patience is a command from the commandments of Allah. واصبروا, be patient. هذا أمر من الله. That's a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْأَمْرُ ثَالِثُ. Third, وَالْفَائِدَةُ ثَالِثَةُ. Benefit number three. أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. That Allah is with those who are patient. مَا مَعْنَى أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. What does it mean Allah is with those who are patient? أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى يُؤَيِّدُهُمْ. That Allah aids them. وَيُحَافِظُ عَلَيْهِمْ. And Allah Ta'ala preserves and protects them. وَأَنْ يُبَارِكَ فِيهِمْ. And He blessed them. وَأَنْ يُعَانِنَهُمْ. And that He aids and supports them. وَأَنْ يُبَصِيرَهُمْ. وَيُبَصِيرَهُمْ. And that Allah, He sees them. مِنْ فَوْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ السَّبْعِ. From above the seven heavens. كما يليق جلاله. In a manner that befits His Majesty. In a manner that befits His Majesty. قال الإمام ابن باز رحمه الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Sheikh ibn Baz continues. قال يعني اصبروا على طاعة الله وترك معصيته. He says, meaning, be patient upon carrying out the obedience of Allah, and be patient upon leaving off those things from the sins, from the prohibitions of Allah. وَاحْذَرُوا مُخَالَفَةَ أَمْرِهِ وَارْتِكَابَ نَهْيِهِ. And beware, beware from opposing and contradicting His commandments. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. And beware for falling into those things that He has prohibited. فَعَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ أَنْ يَحْذَرُوا مِنَ الْوُقُوعِ فِي الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ وَمِنَ الْوُقُوعِ فِي مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ وماذا ومن الوقوع فيما لا يرضي الله. It's upon the Muslim to beware and be cautious not to fall into those sins and those prohibitions, and to beware not to fall into those things that Allah Ta'ala is not pleased with and that Allah Ta'ala does not love. قال الإمام قال الإمام شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله تعالى. So the Imam continues, may Allah have mercy upon him. قال والدليل قوله تعالى, as he says, and the proof to this, O my beloved brothers, is the statement of Allah, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. سورة العصر. He says, and the proof of all of this is the surah, Surah Al-Asr. As Allah Ta'ala says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, by the time, verily mankind is in a state of loss, except those who believe and perform actions of righteousness and exhort one another to truth and exhort one another to patience. Surah Al-Asr. Qala Shaykh Al-Allama, Abdul Aziz ibn Baz Rahimahullah. So the great Imam, Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, he continues. قال وهذا هو الدليل على هذه المسائل الأربع. So he says, this is the proof for all of these four affairs. ما هو الأمر الأول? What's the first affair, يا إخوان? الأمر الأول العلم. The first affair is knowledge. وهو معرفة الله ومعرفة نبيه ومعرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة. First affair is knowledge. Knowledge of what? Knowledge of Allah, His Prophet, and the religion of Al-Islam بالأدلة, with the proofs. Allahu Akbar. لابد من أدلة. It's a must that the person learns the texts. He learns the proofs. والأمر الثاني, second affair. ما هو يا إخوة? What's the second affair? العمل به. نعم. That the person works by this knowledge. العلم بلا عمل كالكنز بدون مفتاح. Knowledge without action is like having a treasure chest, but you can't find the keys. You don't have the keys. العلم بلا عمل كالمسجد بدون المسلمين. Knowledge with no action is like having a masjid and no Muslims. لا يحضره المسلمون. None of the Muslims come to that particular place of worship. لا ينفع. No benefit. العلم بلا عمل كالبيت بدون سقف. Knowledge with no action is like a house without a roof. لا ينفع. It's not going to benefit. لا بد من العلم. It's a must that the person has knowledge. ولا بد من العمل. And it's a must that the person works in accordance with this knowledge. والعلم بلا عمل من أوصاف اليهود. And having knowledge with no action is from the descriptions of the Jews. It's from the descriptions of the Jews. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. فلا بد من العمل. فلا بد من العمل. So it's a must that the person, he works in conformity with the knowledge that he has, with the knowledge that she possesses. لا بد من العلم ولا بد من العمل. It's a must that you learn, and it's a must that you work in accordance with this knowledge. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال شيخ ابن باز. شيخ ابن باز continues. قال ففي هذه الصورة العظيمة الحجة لهذه الأمور وهذا هو الدين كله. So he says, in this tremendous chapter of the Quran is a proof for these affairs. And these affairs encompass the whole of Al-Islam. فالدين كله إيمان وعمل ودعوة وصبر. So he says, the religion, all of it, it is a religion of belief. And the religion, all of it is a religion of action. And the religion, all of it is a religion of calling. And all of it is a religion of patience. إيمان بالحق وعمل به. He says, having iman in the truth, and working once again, working by the truth. وَدَعْوَةٌ إِلَيْهِ and calling to the truth. Allahu Akbar. وَصَبْرٌ عَلِ الْأَذَىٰ فِيهِ and being patient upon the harm that may come. وَنَاسُ كُلُّهُمْ فِي خَسَارَةٍ and all of the people are in a state of loss. As Allah Ta'ala mentions, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا except those who believe in Allah. وَأَمِنُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ and those who perform actions of righteousness. Actions. لَبُدَّ مِنْ الْعَمَلِ it's a must that the person has action. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا except those who believe. وَأَمِنُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ and perform actions of righteousness. And performs actions of righteousness. قال أي الذين استثناهم الله سبحانه وتعالى في جميع بني آدم في خسران وعلى طريقة الهلاك إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتوصوا بالحق وتوصوا بالصبر. Sheikh Ibn Abbasi says, meaning those that are an exception from those that Allah Ta'ala has mentioned from Bani Adam who are in a state of loss, who are they? He says they are those who are on the path of destruction, who are the ones that Allah made an exception for them. He says they are those who believe in Allah and perform actions of righteousness and they exhort one another to truth and exhort one another to patience. قال الشيخ ابن باز رحمه الله فهؤلاء هم الرابحون وهم السعداء وقد أقسم الله تعالى هذا بقوله والعصر. الشيخ ابن باز رحمه الله, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentions that these individuals, who are they? Those who believe and perform actions of righteousness. And what else do? They exhort one another to truth. What else do? They exhort one another to patience. Sheikh Ibn Abbas, he says, these are the ones who have these descriptions. They are the ones who are successful. And they are the ones that are happy. And they are the ones that Allah swore by in this surah, as he says, by the time. Allahu Akbar. قال وهذا صادق سبحانه وتعالى وإن لم يقسم ولكن أقسم لتأكيد المقام. So he says, and he is the truthful, as-sadiqu, the most glorious and the exalted. He said, even if he did not swear, Allah didn't have to swear, honey, ya ikhwan. ليس لله سبحانه وتعالى ليقسم لأي شيء. It's not upon Allah to swear by anything. ليس عليه. It's not incumbent upon him. هو رب السماوات والأرض. He is the Lord of the heavens and the Lord of the earth. رب العالمين. The Lord of all of creation. رب الجن والناس. He's the Lord of the jinn and the Lord of mankind. رب الملائكة. The Lord of the angels. رب الحيوانات. The Lord of the animals. رب السماوات ورب الأرض. رب السماوات ورب الأرض. The Lord of the heavens and the Lord of the earth. لا يلزم ولا لا ماذا لا يوجب الله لا يد ماذا ما أوجب الله سبحانه وتعالى على نفسه أن يقسم ولا يجب على الله سبحانه وتعالى القسم. That is not obligatory upon Allah that he has to swear. لا ولكن يقسم لتأكيد الأمر كما قاله الشيخ العلامة الإمام ابن باز وغيره رحمه الله تعالى. But why does Allah swear sometimes in the Quran? If Allah does not have to swear, then why is Allah swearing? Allah is swearing, ya ikhwan, to show emphasis on the situation. To show emphasis on the affair. ليس لأنه واجبا على الله. Not that it's obligatory upon Allah. لا. ولكن يقسم الله سبحانه وتعالى كما قال الإمام ابن باز هنا وغيره من الأئمة لتأكيد المقام. But as Sheikh Ibn Abbas says, and other than him from the scholars of Al-Islam, why does Allah swear from time to time? Because he's shown emphasis. فَأَحْيَانًا يَقُولُ تَعَالَى وَالْضُحَى. Sometimes Allah says by the duha, the before the noon time. وَأَحْيَانًا قَالَ وَاللَّيْلِ. Sometimes Allah says by the night. وَالشَّمْسِ. Sometimes Allah says, by the sun. وَأَحْيَانًا أَقْسَمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بِنَفْسِهِ. And sometimes you find in the Quran, Allah does what? He swears by himself. He swears by himself. وَهَذَا لِتَأْكِيدِ الْأَمَرِ كُلُّهُ لِتَأْكِيدِ الْأَمَرِ. And all of it is what? To show emphasis on the affair. As Shaykh Ibn Abbas says here, and other than him, from the scholars of Al-Islam. قال شيخ ابن باز بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. شيخ ابن باز continues. قال والله والله سبحانه وتعالى يقسم بما شاء من خلقه فلا أحد يتحجر عليه فأقسم بالسماء ذات البروج. He says, so Allah Ta'ala, He swears by whatever He wishes from the creation. And this is only for Allah. نتوقف هنا يا إخوان. We'll stop here إن شاء الله تعالى. مبينا لأمر مهم. To clarify a tremendous affair. أحيانا الله سبحانه وتعالى يقسم بنفسه. وأحيانا ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقسم بخلقه. And sometimes Allah Ta'ala, He swears by what? The creation. فكل هذا جائز لله. فالله تعالى رب كل شيء. All of this is allowed when it comes to Allah. Allah is the Lord of everything. يَفْعَلُ مَا يُرِيد. Allah Ta'ala can do whatever He wishes. يَقُولُ تَعَالَ فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيد. Surah Al-Buruj. Allah Ta'ala, He says that He does whatever He wishes. He does whatever He wishes. Surah Al-Buruj. وَلَكِنْ بِنِسْبَةِ لَلْمَخْلُوقَاتِ. When it comes to the creation, لَا يَجُوزُ لِلْمَخْلُوقِ أن يقسموا لغير الله سبحانه وتعالى. هذا شرك بالله. هذا شرك بالله. When it comes to creation, the creation is not allowed to swear by other than their creator. Other than their creator. هذا هو الشرك. This is polytheism. فلا بد إذا العبد يريد أن يقسم بالله سبحانه وتعالى أو ليسمت. So when it comes to creation, the creation of Allah has to swear by its creator or shut up or close his mouth. فَإِذَا الْعَبْدُ يُقْسِمُ بِأُمِّهِ. هذا الشرك. So if the servant swears by his mother, I swear on my mother's grave. وَلَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ. هذا الشرك. This is شرك بالله. فَأَحْيَانَ يَقُولُ الْعَبْدُ I swear on my father. أُقْسِمُ بِأَبِي. هذا الشرك. He says, I swear by my father. That's شرك بالله. فلا عبد المسلم يكون حليفا بالله سبحانه وتعالى أو ليصمت. So the servant, the believing, the submissive servant of Allah, the Muslim, either he swears by Allah or he's quiet. Either he swears by Allah or he has to shut up. وسيأتي إن شاء الله تعالى بعض الاستدلالات وبعض الأدلة على هذا الأمر. And inshallah ta'ala, there's some proofs going to come. And we're going to mention them inshallah ta'ala. If Allah ta'ala wills. طيب فالمهم. So the point here. بنسبة إلى ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقسم بما شاء وبمن شاء متى شاء كيف شاء فهو رب السماوات ورب الأرض. So the point here is when it comes to our Lord سبحانه وتعالى, He can swear by whatever He wishes. Whomever He wishes, whenever He wishes, how He wishes. But the servant of Allah, he has to swear when he swears by Allah. فَيَقُولْ مَثَلًا. So he says, for example, وَاللَّهِ, by Allah. أَوْ وَرَبِّي, or by my Lord. أَوْ وَرَبِّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. I swear by the Lord of the heavens and the earth. كُلُّ هَذَا جَائِز. كُلُّ هَذَا جَائِز. All of this is allowed. All of this is Allah. أنا حالف بخالقك. He says, I swear by your creator. هذا جائز. فخالقه هو الله. For indeed his creator is Allah. أنا أحلف بخالقي. I swear by my creator. كل هذا جائز. All of this is allowed. وأحيانا يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. And sometimes you find that the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says, The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says from time to time, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ. Sometimes you find in many ahadith, the phrase, the Prophet says, by the one that the soul of Muhammad is in his hand. هذا جائز. هو يحلف بالله. He's swearing by Allah. He's swearing by Allah. طيب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال شيخ ابن باس فأقسم بالسماء ذات البروج. So sometimes you find Allah Ta'ala says, or is swearing by the heavens, the possessor of the piercing star. وَقْسَمَ بِالسَّمَاءِ وَالطَّارِقُ. And sometimes Allah Ta'ala, he swears by the heavens and the طَارِقُ. وَحْيَانًا بِالدُّوحَى, as we mentioned. And sometimes he swears by the duha, the before noon time, the mid, before the midday. This is called the duha, before the sun inclines to the zenith. This is the duha. وَبِالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا. Sometimes Allah says by the sun and by its duhaha, by its dawn. وَبِاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَقْشَى. And by the night, as it covers. وَبِالنَّازِعَاتِ. And sometimes Allah Ta'ala swears by the nazi'at, when the angels take out the souls. وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. And other than that. لِأَنَّ الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ عِظَمَتِهِ. He says, because the creation itself points to the greatness of the Creator. Allahu Akbar. The creation itself points to what? The greatness of its Creator. Allahu Akbar. التي تدل على طيب قال وعلى أنه سبحانه وتعالى هو المستحق العبادة ولبيان عظم شأن هذه المخلوقات التي تدل على وحدانيته. And the creation also points to the fact that the Creator, not the creation, that the Creator, Allah, He is the one and only one deserving to be worshipped. وَلِبَيَانِ عِظَمِ شَأْنِ هَذِهِ الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ. And it also points to the clarification of the greatness of these affairs that point from the creation, that point to the oneness of the Creator. Allahu Akbar. كَلَامٌ جَمِيلٌ يَا إِخْوَانِ. Some beautiful speech from Sheikh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala. كَلَامٌ جَمِيلٌ. رحمه الله سبحانه وتعالى. Some beautiful words. And may Allah have mercy upon our Shaykh, Shaykh Abdul Aziz ibn Abbas. قال رحمه الله وأنه المستحق للعبادة وحده. He says, and indeed He, Allah, the Creator, is the only one deserving to be worshipped alone. وأما المخلوق فليس له أن يقسم إلا لربه. But as we mentioned, when it comes to the creation, it is only allowed for the creation to swear by its Lord. It's only allowed for the creation to swear by its Lord. وَلَا يُقْسِمُ وَلَا يَحْلِفُ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. So the creation cannot swear by anything or anyone besides Allah. وَلَا يَجُوزُ لَهُ أَنْ يَحْلِفَ بِالْأَنْبِيَاءِ. So it's not allowed for the creation to swear by the prophets and messengers. وَلَا بِالْأَصْنَامِ. Nor is it allowed for the creation to swear by idols. وَلَا بِالصَّالِحِينَ. Nor is it allowed for the creation to swear by the righteous. هَذَا كُلُّهُ حَرَامٌ. All of this is not allowed. وَلَا بِالْأَمَانَةِ. Nor is it allowed to swear by trust. Amana. وَلَا بِالْكَعْبَةِ. Nor is it allowed to swear by the Kaaba. فَإِذَا الْعَبْدُ يَقُلْ مَثَلًا وَبِالْكَعْبَةِ. So if the servant of Allah says, for example, I swear by the Kaaba, هذا الشرك, هذا الشرك, polytheism. ولكن إذا قال ورب الكعبة. But if he says, I swear by the Lord of the Kaaba, هذا جائز, this is allowed. فإذا العبد يقسم أو يحلف علي أن يحلف أو يقسم بالله. So when the servant of Allah swears, he has to swear by the Creator. إذا يقسم بالمخلوق فهذا الشرك. If he swears by the creation, then this is a shirk. قَالَ وَلَا بِغَيْرِهَا. So he continues. And he says, and he does not swear by other than that. قَالَ هَذَا هُوَ الْوَاجِبُ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ لِقَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَىٰ أَلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ. He says, and this is obligatory upon the Muslim when it comes to swearing, based upon the statement of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من حلف بشيء دون الله فقد أشرك. As the Messenger of Allah said, whoever swears by something besides Allah, then he has just committed polytheism. He has fallen into a shirk. فَمَنْ حَلَفَ بِشَيْءٍ دُونَ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ أَشْرَكَ. Whoever swears by something besides Allah, besides his creator, has just committed a shirk. هذا الحديث جاء عند الإمام أبي داود. This hadith comes from the hadith collected by Imam Abu Daud. والإمام الترمذي. وَالْإِمَامُ أَحْمَدْ. And it also comes from Imam al-Tirmidhi and Imam Ahmad. وَالْإِمَامُ الْحَاكِمْ. وَالْإِمَامُ عَبْدُ الرَّزَّاقِ. It also comes from the great Imam عَبْدُ الرَّزَّاقِ. قَالَ كُلُّهُمْ مِنْ حَدِيثِ ابْنِ عُمَرِ. And all of them, they collect the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar. هذا الحديث جاء عن ابن عمر. So this hadith is from the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar or Abdullah ibn Umar. بالعربية, in Arabic you would say جاء عن Abdullah. بالإنجليزية, when you come from English, it's narrated from, you'll just keep it in Arabic, from Abdullah. In عربية جاء عن Abdullah. عن حرف جار. عبد الله اسم مجرور وهو مضاف وعبد مضاف والله مضاف إليه. In Arabic you would say عن عبد الله. عن is a preposition. عبد الله is the noun that is made genitive because of the preposition. عبد is the word and Allah is the word that the first word is attributed to. So you say عن عبد الله. In English, from Abdullah. طيب. قال وجاء عن أبي داود أو عند الإمام أبي داود والترمذي والإمام أحمد والحاكم وعبد الرزاق كلهم من حديث ابن عمر وصححه الألباني في سلسلة الصحيحة رقم 2041. He says, so this hadith is from the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar collected by Imam Abu Dawood and Imam al-Tirmidhi and Imam Ahmed. And Imam Abdul Razzaq in his Musannaf, Kitab al-Azim, a tremendous book. وَسَمِعْنَا مِنْ أَخِينَا فِي اللَّهِ مُعَاذْ أَنَّ الشَّيْخَ الشِّطْرِ لَهُ تَحْقِيقٌ عَلَى الْمُصَنَّفِ لِلْإِمَامِ عَبْدُل رَزَّاقِ. And we've heard from our beloved brother, Mu'adh al-Amriki, that the Imam of our time in Saudiya, the Shaykh Sa'd al-Shittari, that he has a check-in of this book, the Musannaf of Abdul Razak al-San'ani. طيب. And he says, and it was deemed authentic by the great Imam al-Albani. طيب. قال الإمام ابن باس أخرجه الإمام أحمد بإسناد صحيح. And Sheikh ibn Abbas, he says, and this hadith is collected by Imam Ahmed with an authentic chain. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.